using my round brush and just keeping my grip real loose. The dark shadows I'm painting on his horns will show where those curve. Now you can see this branch on the ground since I'm putting the shadow around it. I need delicate lines to create some of the texture in these animals' fur. So I'm holding my brush loosely between my index and middle fingers. This allows my wrist to move, which helps make the lines more wispy. Now I'm using a lighter shade on part of the rock in the background. Blend them with the mop brush and paint a much darker shadow blended underneath. And this combination of the light with the dark colors next to it creates the indents in the rock. I'm using a liner brush to paint details in the dirt. And in the Gnus' fur. I'm using a combination of medium yellow, burnt umber, and just a touch of red to fill in the color on this guy. Trust me, red helps to brighten the color. Without it, it would look more like a mustard yellow. I blocked in the standing Gnu with the same color, but I had to adjust it later on, as you'll see. You may notice that I'm not putting this color on the stripes. That's because I want them to stand out on their own. And so I need to keep the underpainting showing so that the color that I'm going to put on them won't have anything muting it. And remixing my color now. You see I got the yellow down, got some burnt umber, it's a little bit of red, just a little bit, not too much. We don't really want this to look reddish. The red is just to brighten up the color a bit. Still too much of the underpainting showing on the standing Gnu. So I'm just painting another layer on top of him. But again, I'm avoiding the stripes. Oh, but I am going to go over these dark gray shadows on the Gnus because I don't want those to stand out. I want to blend them in with the rest of his fur. I'm mixing a little bit of blue into this color. I'm going to use it to start to intensify the shadows on the standing Gnu, like I'm doing right here. Now I'm ready to paint the stripes, and for that I'm using a very pale, very muted yellow. It's almost white. Okay, I'm taking a little break from the Gnus now to glaze over the plants with a darkish green. Going over the Gnus' horns now with a taupey brown. And emphasizing the shadows on the standing Gnu with a still bluer shadow. Now the ground they're on just happened to be a lighter shade of the same color that I used for their horns. So I just mixed a little bit of transparent mixing white into that. And as you can see here, I'm just glazing that color all over the ground. I really struggled to get these shadows blue enough. I'm not even using the base color anymore here. I'm just using a blue that's just been mixed with a bit of orange to make it more muted and shadowy. Well, the overall tone of the sitting Gnu is more warm, so for his shadows, I'm using a reddish brown. I'm using pretty much the same color that I used for the base, except I'm mixing more red into it because I actually want that reddish tone now. Here I'm mixing a muted pale pink with just a hint of blue for a cool look. Really, just a hint of blue. Barely a dab because I don't want this to turn purple. And I'm glazing this all over the standing new. I'm keeping it translucent on purpose. I really just want to tint that color. And I'm still darkening these shadows. I'm mixing a pale muted purple for the rock. I'm glazing it all over. Now it's finally time to paint the stripes, and in keeping with the different shades of these nudes, I'm painting the stripes on the standing nude a pale pink, and those on the sitting nude a pale yellow. But you can see for both that I'm just using the tip of my liner brush. I made sure that my brush is plenty wet, and there's plenty of paint in it because I want these lines to be smooth. Just for the pure fun of it, I decided to paint the sky Prussian blue. Prussian blue is a color that I really like, but I don't find excuses to use very often. It kind of makes it look like the scene is taking place at night, even though I promise you it's not. I'm mixing the pale muted pink, which I'm going to use for the fluffier fur details in the news. My pink, I'm just mixing a little bit of green in, just to tone it down a bit. I'm using my liner brush, just the tip of it, and holding it between the two fingers. This lets my wrist move, so I can paint those curved fur lines easily. And of course, I blend everything out with a mop brush. Mixing a bluish green. And I'm intensifying the color of these plants by glazing this bluish green color over them. The news horns are very twisty, obviously. Different tones of the shadows and the highlights on them were very important in creating this look. One example is this pale, bold highlight that you see me putting right here. This one here, that lets the viewer know that this side of the horn is catching the light, which means that the side that is not catching the light, aka the shadowy side, is underneath it. Hey, you might like this video on how I painted a zebra, with emphasis on how I curved the stripes to create the rounded shape of his body. Click the card in the upper right-hand corner to go watch it, and don't forget to subscribe so I can help you bring out your creativity. Thanks for watching!